Okay.
Thank you.
for Wisconsin's Queen. Since 1968, young women from all over the world have made the trip to Ohio for a chance of a lifetime to compete in the Congress for the title of the All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen. The Congress Queen serves as an ambassador and spokeswoman for the Ohio Quarter Horse Association and for the Congress, welcoming spectators and exhibitors and assisting in the presentation of nearly $3.5 billion in cash and prizes over the course of nearly 4 weeks. Her reign does not end at the conclusion of the Congress, as she will make many appearances at many major events throughout the year, and of course she wins a very impressive prize package as well. Most importantly, she will make a lifetime of memories and join a strong sisterhood of previous queens. This year we'll be crowning our 55th Congress Queen. The Congress Queen is selected based on poise, industry knowledge, an equestrian skill assessed through a professional interview, a written exam, and the Queen's Horsemanship class. Today is it our pleasure to introduce our candidates and recognize their accomplishments in these categories and to crown the overall winner of the 2023 All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen. And first up, representing the Indiana Quarter Horse Association, please welcome Jessica Blevins. Yeah. She's kind of tall, and I'm kind of short. Jessica, how do you get to compete for the title of All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen?
If you are a female quarter horse enthusiast between the ages of 18 and 25, you can contact a state association to figure out how to become their queen. After becoming queen, you then get three opportunities to vie for the title of the All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen.
Thank you, Jessica. And now representing the Kentucky Quarter Horse Association, please welcome Emma Rittenberry. So tell me about your interview portion of the contest.
So this year the interview is for 50% of your entire score. There was a panel of four judges, and they interviewed you based upon your application and your personality.
Thank you, Emma. And now representing the Michigan Quarter Horse Association, please welcome Rachel Bowers. Rachel, how did you prepare for the interview, and what were some of the questions you were asked?
I prepared for the interview by talking to last year's interview winner, Sarah Beth Belker, and she gave me lots of tips and tricks. And then one of the questions that I was asked was, what are three characteristics you have gained since becoming queen that will help you as a teacher? Because I'm going to be a teacher.
Thank you. And now representing the New York State Quarter Horse Association, please welcome Emily Carey. All right, Emily, tell me about the written exam portion of the contest.
Ohio Pro Horse Association facts, history of the Congress facts,
Thank you, Emily. Now representing the Ohio, Michigan, Indiana Quarter Horse Association, please welcome Brianna Rausch. Hi, Brianna. How did you prepare for the exam, and what were some of the questions you were asked? Thank you, Rhea. And now representing the Ohio Quarter Horse Association, please welcome Ashton Snow. Hi, Ashton. Tell me about the horsemanship portion of the contest.
Score, and riders were asked to do an individual pattern and then went back for
rower. Thank you, Ashton. And now representing the Pennsylvania Quarter Horse Association, please welcome Rachel Lexon. Tri-State Quarter Horse Association, please welcome Madison Heilebile. You definitely win the award for the most challenging last name by far. Tell us about your surprise trip.
After our interviews and thanking some more of our vendors, we went bowling, which is a great way to decompress after a long day. A common favorite food among some of these contestants is ice cream, so we concluded the night with enjoying some ice cream.
Excellent. Thank you, Madison. Next up, representing the Virginia Quarter Horse Association, please welcome Carson Green. You do during your Queen Week? PJ party, cocktail party, heroes and horses, vendors, photos, what else did you do?
We ate lots of food. Tons of food. Thank you to the Sweet Shop, who actually sponsored us by feeding us lots of yummy food. I got to try my very first Sweet Shop cinnamon roll for the first time. It was absolutely fantastic.
I've had lots of cinnamon rolls. Thank you. Next up, representing the West Virginia Quarter Horse Association, please welcome Caitlin Chrisman. What advice do you have for a little girl who is watching who wants to be Congress Queen someday?
Just go for it, practice your horsemanship, and just really chase after that dream.
Thank you, Caitlin. How about another round of applause for all our queen candidates this year? And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 2022 All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen, Miss Kylie Good.
Thank you.
favorite event of the over 20 places you travel to?
Oh my gosh, so just having the opportunity to travel the country with my family was just a blessing this year, but I will say that the Arizona Sun Circuit was one of my most favorite because my mom, dad, and sister were able to attend with me, and it was just absolutely beautiful there.
Who are some of the people you'd like to thank? Ladies and gentlemen, Congress Queen, Kylie Good. And now for the results. The interview portion is worth 50 points, the candidate's overall score. And here are your top four placings. Placing fourth, Jessica Blevins from the Indiana Quarter Horse Association. Placing third, Ashton Snow from the Ohio Quarter Horse Association. Placing second, Morgan Askins from the South Carolina Quarter Horse Association. Winning the interview portion of the results was Emily Carey from the New York State Quarter Horse Association. And now on to the written exam portion, worth 30 points of the candidate's overall score. Fourth place goes to Caitlin Crispin from West Virginia Quarter Horse Association. Placing third, Madison Heilevay from the Tri-State Quarter Association. Placing second, Rihanna Roush from the Ohio, Michigan, Indiana Quarter Association. And winning the written exam portion, Jessica Blevins from Indiana. And now on to the horsemanship portion worth 20 points. Fourth place goes to Rachel Bowers from Michigan Quarter Horse Association. Receiving third place, Rachel Lexon from the Pennsylvania Quarter Horse Association. Second place, Emma Rittenberry from the Kentucky Quarter Association. And winning the horsemanship portion, Ashton Snow from the Ohio Quarter Association. It is now time to announce the winner of the Miss Congeniality. Miss Congeniality is awarded to the most congenial candidate as selected by her peers. This year's winner is Rachel Lexon from the Pennsylvania Quarter Horse Association. Congratulations, Rachel. And now for the overall results. The overall results are not based on the section places, but are based on the combined point totals from each of the three sections. The second runner-up for the title of the 2023 All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen is Caitlin Crispin from the West Virginia Quarter Horse Association. Congratulations, Caitlin. And now the first runner-up for title of the 2023 All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen. Congratulations to Madison Heilemeyer from the Tri-State Quarter Horse Association. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce your 2023 All-American Quarter Horse Congress Queen, Miss Jessica Blevin. Jessica is the daughter of Ryan and Jane Blevins. She was born and raised in rural Indiana on her family's grain and small horse farm. Jessica attends the Kelly School of Business and Hutton Honors College at Indiana University, where she is majoring in accounting with a co-major in real estate. Throughout her reign in Indiana, Jessica has used her platform to help promote awareness and raise funds for local therapeutic riding programs. Jessica's mission is to be a positive role model for younger quarter horse enthusiasts. Ladies and gentlemen, your queen, Jessica Blevin. Today. Once again, congratulations to Congress Queen Jessica Blevins, representing the Indiana Quarter Horse Association. That does conclude our forum. We thank everyone for coming and supporting our queen. And don't forget, enjoy your time here at the All-American Quarter Horse Congress. Thank you.